Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. I just want to welcome all my new subscribers. Thank you for joining, love having you all. And also thank you to my returning subscribers. So today we're going to be doing What's the Gossip on You, because it was so popular the other month when I did it. So what I'm going to do is stick with monthly readings on What's the Gossip, monthly readings on my karma, and monthly readings on my messages from deceased loved ones, because I love doing these readings. Pick a pile. So pile one, we've got this brooch here. I think that's amethyst. Yeah, that is amethyst. Pile two, we have jade green, call it what you want. And pile three, we have, I think that's aquamarine, or blue, if you want to call it blue, pin. So you choose your pile, and don't forget this is a collective reading. If it's not your reading today, choose something else. I've got loads of videos in the playlist. And also take what resonates, leave what doesn't, don't force anything. And just to let you know quickly, I am open to doing personal readings. You'll find everything in the description box down below. So anyway, I'll see you at your polls. So my lovely pile ones, if you chose, I don't even know why I'm talking like my ones. Amethyst, this is your reading, for God's sake. I'm in one of those moods today. So what we're going to do, put this aside first. So we're going to find out what the gossip is on you guys, then we're going to find out who these people are, and then go with the tarot, okay? So spirit, what is the gossip on my pile ones? Oh, hang on, what are you doing in there? Okay, wrong pile. Okay, so, no, do you know what? No, I'll leave it. Spirit's saying leave it. Okay, let's do that again. So what is the gossip on my pile ones? What is the gossip on my pile ones? Big mad, very triggered, mad as F, angry about situation or someone. So I'm going to get a few first, okay guys? So just bear with me and then we'll talk about what the gossip is on you, alright? Right. So we've got snooping, I'll read them in a minute. Then we've got a fake friend. Oh, charming. Get one more, or whatever flies out from my pile one. There we go. And that one. And that one. So we've got gold digger. Air sign. So you could be an air sign. Oh, and a home wrecker. My pile one. So this is juicy. So the gossip on you at the moment, pile one, is that you get mad, you get angry about. I'm picking up more, not on the situation, I'm picking up more on someone. So from these cards here, what I'm seeing is the gossip about you is that you may be, not maybe, the gossip is that you're peed off because maybe someone chose somebody else, or they're with that person. And this, right, look, I'm trying to explain it. From what I'm getting here, this fake friend here is going around telling everybody that you're peed off because the person that they're with, girl, man, whatever, you're peed off because they're not with you. You're jealous. This is what I'm picking up here, okay? So it could be a friend. And we've got snooping. Always in your business, ask questions about you, looking over your shoulder for deets. So basically they call you, and as we say here, a nosy parker, that you're always in people's business. You want to know about this situation. It could be about, you know, this couple here. Fake friend, that you're fake is what people are saying. A fake friend who is not genuine, two-faced, so you're two-faced, talks about you behind your back, using you for clout. So it could be, you know, clout would make sense with the gold digger there. Not that this is true, pile one, you know. Here for a good laugh. So basically you're fake, you're there for what you can get out of people, you know, you're a gold digger, you use people for money, you know, it says a user only liking people for money, primary interest in material benefits. So this could be you, an air sign, which is Aquarius, Gemini, Libra, or it could involve someone who is an air sign, okay? You are a home wrecker. So this, I'm picking up strong vibe here that this person is going around telling people that you're trying to come between her, I'm going to say her and her partner. You're trying to break up their happy home. You know, you want what she's got. So yeah. Yeah, lovely friend or whoever this is. Now let's find out who this is first. So spirit, tell me who this is that's gossiping about my power ones. Tell me who this is. Someone who is middle-aged, or, you know, not necessarily middle-aged. They could be someone that is not aging gracefully. So who is this? Social media. You get to know this person through social media networks. So this could be someone that you do networking with. It could be that you've both got a platform together. This could be someone that has a platform, you know, like it could be a tarot reader, you know, an influencer. So this person's got a social media platform. This is the same sex as you. So like I said, if it is a female and you're female, or male, so it's the same sex as you, okay? This person could be quite similar to you. Get a few more of who this is. Who is this? Who is this spirit? Oh, look, we've got definitely got strong air sign here. Aquarius has come out again. Hey, fellow Aquarians. Unconditional, quirky, intelligent, free-spirited, unique, rebellious, friendly, but can get detached and aloft as well. So this person can come across as being quite cold. That's what they like to say about us Aquarians, but it's not true, really. This is a friend. So you've got two friendship cards here. So this is a very strong energy of a friend here, pile one. And they're medium height. So let's get physical features now on this energy here, okay? To give you a bit more, you know... Spirit, give please tell us what this energy's physical features are, please, for my pile one. What are the physical features of this energy? We have dark brown eyes. Now look at this, we've got another really, but I'm taking this, there's a T card in here. Physical and mental transformation for, right, so you've had a glow up. This person hates the fact, you know, some of you can be young, or you just had a glow up, or you just, you know, coming, you know, you're aging gracefully, you know, like a fine wine, pile one. So yeah, they there's jealousy there, or there could be just talk about your looks. Plain clothes. So this person wears plain clothes. What are the physical features of this energy here, spirit, that's gossiping about my pile ones? They're a tomboy as well. They may like to dress like a bit of a tomboy. So a few more. Italian descent. Okay. Right. Short nose. Plus size for some of you. And one more, please, spirit. They're classy, so they obviously have a classy look about them for some of you, and they love to wear watches and bracelets. Okay, so take what resonates, like I said, guys. Let's get some more information on this gossip about you, my pile one. So what is this energy gossiping about? My pile one, spirit. Queen of Materials. Oh, jealousy, jealousy. Tell us a bit more. Let's get a few more. Actually, let me brighten my ring light, guys. It's a bit dull. A bit better. Tell us a bit more about the gossip on my pile ones. Five of swords. I need a few more guys, okay? We've got Awakening and we've got Queen of Emotions, and the overall energy is strength on the back of the deck. Right, okay, the gossip on you, my pile ones, that is going around about you is that you are a money grabber. You are out for what you can get. You hang around people that are wealthy, that do well for themselves. You know, you, like I said, this person can have a social media platform, or they, you know, a business owner basically, and you're only hanging out with them because you want the clout, you want the benefits and the rewards that come with that. Okay. The gossip on you as well, my pile ones, is not very nice. The gossip is that you're very insecure, you're very needy, very sulky. And this would actually, I don't like, really like talking about things like body shaming and stuff like that, because I think it's freaking horrible. But because you've had this glow up and this person's jealous of you, which there is strong jealousy here, they take the mick out of your weight. You could have had weight problems in the past, and that could be where you've had this glow up, where you may have lost the weight. That's for some of you, okay? I'm hearing the name Lily. Don't know why I'm hearing the name Lily, and I'm seeing red hair as well. So this person could have red hair, or you could have red hair. Yeah. So you're just out for what you can get, and that goes with the gold digger theory here, you know, the gossip. And the Five of Swords. Whoever this friend is, pile one, they're really not a nice person. Maybe you need to look at your inner circle and figure out who it is that's actually the one that's gossiping about you, because I'm picking up only on one energy here, okay? With the Five of Voices, which is the Five of Swords, the gossip on you is that you don't succeed in nothing. You know, I'm trying to phrase it in such a nice freaking way. How can I phrase it without sounding horrible? I mean, you're sitting there going, just say it. But some people get sensitive about these sort of things, you know. They say that you're basically a thief, that you steal ideas, you're just out to get what you want, is what I said. It's a lot to do with surrounding about, the energy is about money and appearances, okay? That you're not amounting to anything. People don't really like you. You know, that's with the Five of Swords here that I'm getting. And with 20, the Awakening, which is Judgment. This person judged you before they even really got to know you, you see. And if you are an Aquarian, which I'm an Aquarian, we tend to get judged quite a lot for, you know, being closed off, like what you said, not being approachable. But that's not the case. It's Aquarians, they have a hard time of trusting people. I am one of them. But once you gain our trust, we are very, very friggin' loyal. You know, really, like, you know, defend you to the death, basically. So yeah, this person judged you before they even really got to know you, and I do believe it's to do with appearances. I do believe there is such insecurity with this energy here that it's like they're projecting, you know. So the Queen of Emotions has come out, which is the Queen of Cups. Now, they're saying that you're like this. There's a lot of gossip about you here, pile one. There's the way they're describing you to people is just so, like, outrageous. It's like, so OTT, you know. We've once again got that you're insecure with yourself, you know, that you're very needy, you're very sulky, you know, you're unfaithful, you're not to be trusted. And with the Strength card here, I see the Strength as sometimes like a sexual card. So what I'm hearing here is that this person tells people that you like to sleep around, you use your body to get what you want, you know, like the material things here. So yeah, wow. Oh, let's get a few more tarot cards here. We've got a Seven of Swords, which explains everything. Six of Swords, Nine of Swords, Ten of Swords. Wow. This energy is so up in their head about you. It's like they're obsessed with you. They are obsessed with you. It could even be, like I said, you could even have a platform, and this is where the jealousy comes from, that, you know. It could be that you've got a platform, you're an influencer to do with makeup, or, you know, something like that. So I do feel like you are someone that's in the limelight and you are very attractive. And they are so obsessed with you because with the Four of Pentacles, it's someone that can't let go, someone that is obsessing. And all these Swords cards here is being up in your head, you know. So with the Seven of Swords, this is a sneaky energy here. This is someone that lies, steals, cheats, you know, tries to get away with things. This is a very sneaky energy, and the gossip on you is that is the energy of you. But no, this is the energy of them. Hence the projection. And with the Six of Swords here, you know, I'm picking up here, you just want to get on with this person. Maybe they're in a friendship group and there's no way of avoiding this person, you know. You're stuck with them. For some of you, I don't know why I'm picking up that they could be with your brother or your sister, so a sibling. It could be their partner, so you're definitely stuck with them, if you know what I mean. And you would like things to be smoothed out. You would like them to stop, you know, projecting and being nasty, but they're not. They're going to continue. This person has a lot of sleepless nights over you. God, oh my God, the obsession over you. It's actually kind of creepy. Pile one. Really, really creepy. This person sits up late at night. I think they stalk your social media. Trying to, you know, looking at your pictures. And I do, in a way, I sort of feel a bit, you know, because I've got empathy and stuff, I do feel kind of a bit sad here when I've got to this card, that I do feel like this person has cried a few times over the fact that they're not you. And that's very sad. Very, very sad. You know, they're punishing you because they can't be you. Oh, so creepy. Oh, my God. Wow. And this, you know, you've got 9 and 10 here. 10 of Swords is they feel like you betrayed them. Why do they feel like you betrayed them? But then you can look at this card in the other way, that they're betraying you. They constantly keep backstabbing you, you know, gossiping about you, talking crap about you. Let me just I want to clarify the 7 and the 10 of Swords. Clarify the 10 of Swords for me, please, Spirit. Clarify the 10 of Swords. Stay with me, guys. I need another one. Tell me about justice. Queen voices, Queen of Swords. Wow, four queens here, and the Four of Swords, Three of Swords. Oh, what the heck? Oh, my dog. Do you know what? My dog barking like that, this is like this energy here, that they're vicious, even though my dog's not vicious, she's just a grumpy old cow. She has a go at my other dogs. Yeah. This is somebody that is just, I'm just going to say it, they're very abusive with the Justice card here. They're in some kind of power, or they're on a power trip here. And they get satisfaction out of actually hurting you with the Ten of Swords and the Three of Swords on the back of the deck. You know, they like seeing you hurt. They like seeing you suffer. This is the Queen of Swords. This is someone that goes around with a, you know, they've got a lot of deep wounds, but they've been so affected by, you know, their past, that they are now a very cold, horrible energy, basically. You know, the Queen of Swords, she can be seen as someone very horrible at times, and very cold and very distant, and this is an air sign as well, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius again. We have fire sign here, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces as well. So you've got quite the whole lot here. But the main dominant sign is air. So yeah, with the Queen of Swords here, she is somebody that is just malicious. She's just cruel, and she's very obsessive with you. She's obsessed with you, because the Queen of Swords can become very obsessed. And you see how these two queens here, you know, you've come out as three queens here, the Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Cups, and the Queen of Wands. And the Queen of Wands is the most beautiful woman in the deck, in my eyes, okay? You know, you're beautiful inside and out. You light up a room. People turn to stare at you. You can be male as well watching this, and you can be handsome. So yeah, but you see the way their heads are turned away from each other. This is two people, two energies here that don't see eye to eye, but it's mainly coming from the Queen of Swords here. She's so jealous that you are someone that is doing very well for themselves. You know, you're strong, you're passionate, you're independent. You're sexy, you're confident, you know, I can go on and on and on, and they hate that. And they're always in their head about this. I mean, it's like the mental exhaustion. I mean, I don't know why they just don't just give up. I mean, another scenario here that I'm hearing is, could be that you ended up with their partner. You know, maybe this person is the karmic. So that's another, you know, example. Take what resonates. But I want to know what this person's up to, because the Seven of Swords is here and I don't like that. So tell me about the Seven of Swords from a Pile One Spirit. So we have Seven of Materials, Seven of Pentacles, the King of Pentacles, and the Sun, and the Three of Swords again. Okay, what I just said there, basically, that this could be a karmic that for some of you, that is, their partner has obviously left them to be with you. You know, I'm not saying there was any cheating here, but, you know, it could have been a third party situation with the Three of Swords there. But this is what I'm seeing here, that the bitterness is coming from the fact that you are with this karmic's ex. The other scenario is what I said at the beginning, where this person thinks that they're the bee's knees and you want their partner, okay? It's just insecurity and it's projection. So they don't want this to work out. They don't want you and your King of Pentacles. You know, we've got a couple here. We've got, you two are a couple. So if that's the case for you guys, they don't want it to work out. They're hoping that it's not going to work out. You know, they're hoping it's not going to go anywhere. And this person's planting little seeds, you know, seeds of doubt, basically, in the King of Pentacles' head here. Or even in your head, to make you feel insecure and maybe walk away and cause heartbreak, you know, and a breakup of a connection here, because the Three of Swords is a relationship ending. It's unrequited love as well. So this is why I'm getting quite a few messages here, because I'm feeling like this King of Pentacles doesn't love this energy here. They love you. You know, you are the sun. You bring them happiness and joy. They are, with the seven of swords and the Seven of Pentacles here, they are planning something. What are they planning, Spirit? They're planning. What are they planning? Also hearing the names Simone and Andy. Spirit, tell me about this Seven of Pentacles. Yeah, look, the Magician. Manipulation. They're planning something here. They're trying to get away with something. And like I said, there could be planting seed of doubt in your King of Pentacles is mind. They could be planting seed of doubt in your mind if you're not even aware that this person hates you that much, because this is hate. This is not just a normal jealousy here. This is like deep-rooted, like obsessive behavior from this energy here. So they're planning something with the Magician. They're wearing a mask around you. You know, I feel like it's all mind games here with this energy, okay? So it could either be towards you, it could be towards your person, if you're involved with someone. So they are planning on just causing confusion. So it's either something they're going to say or something they're going to do, but I think it's more they're going to say. To put you in the Two of Voices, which is the Two of Swords, is just total confusion. Okay, let's get some advice for you guys, okay? This energy is peeing me off. Ugh, I don't know why you're even friends with this energy. Spirit, what advice? But I do believe most of you are not even aware. I forgot what I was going to say. I'm so confused. And that's what I just said. This person, it's like, oh my God. Literally got confused there myself, because this is what they're planning on doing. They're planning on literally confusing you, that you don't know whether you're coming or you're going. And this person is a master manipulator. They're very clever, so just be careful, pile one. So what advice would you give my pile ones? Okay, you nearly came out. What advice would you give my pile ones? Okay, right, Two of Inspiration as well. This is, I like this, Ten of Emotions. Spirit is saying you need to stand in your Emperor power, okay? You need to find your masculine. You need to find that part of you, because we've got feminine and masculine in us. So Spirit wants you to take control of this situation, okay? You need to prioritize yourself and the people around you. So you need to be the emperor when it comes to this person. And I do believe what spirit is saying is that once you get in that emperor energy here, pile one, you are going to be closing the door on this situation here. You're going to be closing the door on this person. You know, you're going to put it in a little box and you're going to chuck it away and not think about this person. Okay, because the world is endings. It's an ending of a chapter. You're done. And look at this here with the fall. You're moving forward into a new beginning. You're leaving it all behind. You're not even giving this person a backwards glance. You know, with the two of wands here, this is you going down a different road. You're choosing that path and you're leaving that, this all behind. You know, this is spirit's advice to you, is what to do. It's whether you do it or not, but I do feel like you will eventually do it. So I do like that ending there. That was nice. So let me get some letters. I'm just gonna get letters. I'm not gonna get no charms. Okay, see what the bear with me. Not so many letters. So some letters. Alright. Some letters. So this could be their initials. It could be letters in their name. So, you know, give you a rough idea of who this is. So we've got the letter T. The letter S. I said Simone. E. I. E again, Q, C, R, D, quite a few here, Z, no, N, sorry, can't freaking read, S, W, Q again, and J. So this person could have these letters in their name, or it could be their initials that's here. I can even spell out a name, you know. So yeah, my pile ones, I'm going to leave it there. I hope this resonated for you. If it did, please hit like and comment down below. Feel free, love hearing from all of you, and you take care. Have a lovely day. Hey, pile two, so if you chose this green pin, this is your reading. So I'm going to put tarot cards over there first. So let's find out what the gossip is on you first. Ooh. So, Spirit, tell me, what is the gossip on my pile twos? Taking shortcuts, not doing your job well, not fulfilling commitments, lazy, causing more work for others. So, it could be a work environment here that people are gossiping about you at work, that you're lazy when it comes to doing your job, my pile two. So, what is the gossip on my pile twos? Okay, got quite a few there. So we've got, you're clingy, somebody that cannot let go. So you are someone, well, the gossip on you is that you're very clingy. Could be that the gossip is that you're clingy when it comes to partners, and that you're broke, no money, can't pay bills, scraping up change to get by. So basically you're broke, you can't afford to buy things. Well, do you know what? Pile one was, I'm picking up petty energy today, guys. Ghosted, ignoring you, not calling or texting back, avoiding confrontation. So it could be that the gossip on you is that you've ignored this person and they're sour about it. It could be because you know that they're toxic, that you're just not bothering communicating with them, you know, which I don't bloody blame you, to be honest. And a star, being popular, very successful, having a platform, being recognised and known. So it could be my pole too, so that you guys have a social media platform, you know, it could be an influencer, you could be in the limelight, and this person's jealous about that, you know, there could be gossip about how you got there, or, you know, that kind of thing. It's just jealousy. I'm picking up pettiness with this pile. So let us have a look who this person is first, or people. So Spirit, tell me about this energy. Who is this that's gossiping about my pile twos? Who is this gossiping about pile two? someone local to you. This one is living in the same area, city or country as you. So someone that lives local. They could be a Cancer, protective, loving, sensitive, compassionate, gentle. When out of balance, we'll get clingy. So we're looking at the negative sides of these cards, okay? So ignore the first bit. They can be clingy, jealous, pessimistic, easily hurt and dramatic. Now, that is the audacity of that. The projection is quite laughable, really, because they're calling you clingy when it's the other way around. I mean, it looks like they've got the ump with you because you ghosted them. There may have been that you didn't have time to actually text back or call back, you know, if you're busy being a star, you know. So who is this energy that's gossiping about my pile? Two, ten of small. Middle-aged. You might want to look at pile one, guys. Similar sort of cards came out. So this person could be middle-aged, could be older than you, may be feeling a bit jealous because maybe you're younger. Aquarius, yeah, definitely take a look at pile one. So this is someone that is unconventional, quirky, intelligent, free-spirited, unique, rebellious, friendly, but can get detached and aloof. So this person can be come across as being cold towards you. I mean, it even can be that, you know, if you've got a platform, you're working with others on that platform and they think you're lazy and, you know, the limelight's all on you and you don't do the work and I do more of the work. That's what I'm hearing. It's just petty jealousy. Number nine, ninth house. Impulsive, argumentative, critical, conceited, destructive. So this person's very critical of you, very argumentative when it comes to maybe ideas. I think you work with this person. You work together. This is someone that's very energetic as well, like can't keep still. Okay, so let's get some physical features on this energy here. Tell me, Spirit, what are the physical features of this person gossiping about my pile tools? They want to come out. So they could have a muscular build, middle-aged again. So this is someone older than you. They could have dark skin. They have high cheekbones. I am picking up a feminine energy here, short nose. Let's get a couple more. So let's more about the physical features on this gossiper. Pile twos. They could be curvy. Lavish, trendy dress. So they like to dress lavishly, you know. They like to wear watches and bracelets. And they get two more. All right, yeah. Blonde hair. And the last one is thin eyebrows, okay? They could get their eyelashes permed as well. They could be into that. So let's find out more for you, my pile two. So Spirit, tell me, what is the gossip? Oh, look at this. Sneaky, sneaky. Past life, your soul recognized your soul from the moment they met you. So you could have a soul contract with this person. I feel it's very weird that that's in there. That's not even in the box. That's actually on my window over there. So how that got in there, I don't know. But it's there for a reason. You could have a soul contract with this person. So this person follows you from life to life to life. I bet you're thinking, for God's sake. So yeah, there's a soul contract here. Right, okay. So we've got Temperance. Ten of Wands. Let's get a couple more. What is the gossip on my pile twos? What is this person gossiping about? So this person's gossiping at the moment, from what I can see with Temperance there, that you don't balance out the situation. You cause discord, basically, in conflict. You can be quite excessive in your spending. Yeah, that's what I'm hearing with Temperance. Even though it is in a peace and harmony, I'm not looking at it like that. And with the Ten of Wands here, this is all about burdens, you know, grief, worries. Five of Wands, yeah. You could be having back problems, pile two. You could be suffering with your back, okay? And it could be where maybe you can't do certain things because this person's so energetic, but you're not, you know? I mean, I suffer with back problems, and Jesus, I'd rather give birth. So the gossip on you is that because you don't take care of yourself with temperance here, you know, that's why you've got back problems. That's why you're like this. But like I said, it's like petty jealousy. And with the Five of Wands, this is like conflict. This is people ganging up on someone else. It could be like work environment where there's loads of arguments. And I feel like there is, you've had quite a lot of humdingers with this person. That could be why you're ghosting them, because you're just done with it, that you can't be bothered to be arguing with them anymore, you know. This is with the Five of Wands, I'm picking up rival. They see you as a rival. So I'm getting, you know, if it is a social media platform, it could be that you're in the same sort of, you're doing the same sort of thing, okay? If you're influencers or whatever, or if a tarot reader, and this person can't stand you. They don't like the competition. They see this young girl or young man come along, and, you know, you've got it going on, and maybe because they've aged, you know, and they're not so young, it's just so petty. It really is. It's very sad. So you've had a lot of problems with this person here. This energy here could like, this energy here may like to drink a lot of herbal tea. So that could be somebody that, you know. Tell us more. What is the gossip? Spirit, my part two. What's the gossip from my pile too? Okay, I'll take it. Seven of Cups. So we've got Seven of Wands, Three of Cups, Two of Pentacles, Queen of Cups. Yeah, I wouldn't say friendship, even though the Three of Cups is friendship. I need to just get that, drop something. Even though the Three of Cups is a friendship group, okay, I feel like it is a work environment here. Can be a friendship group. Could be that you started this online business together as a group of three. And you've got the one that's the sour one, you know. They say two companies, three's a crowd, you know. So, you know, take what resonates here. And this energy here is telling people that you're very stubborn, that you're standing your ground here. So you could even be the Aquarius, because Aquarians are very stubborn. You know, you're very stubborn. You're not wanting to budge on anything. You're not listening. And you're causing the problems in the dynamic, in the work environment here. This energy could be telling people that you're actually looking elsewhere to move on and do, you know, how can I explain it? That you're looking at other options, because we've got the Seven of Cups here, okay? It could be that maybe that is what you're doing because you're fed up with it, right? So the gossip is about you at the moment is that you want to leave. You could be talking to other people, going, you know, wanting to move into a different field or work with different people. And this energy is talking about that to other people. They're really not happy about this, if that's what you are planning on doing, pile two. So that is the gossip surrounding you at the moment, that you have other options. You could have had someone approach you and offer you, you know, a better job. Yeah, there's jealousy here. We've got Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces here. We've got Sagittarius as well. So with the Queen of Cups, this energy is telling people that you're very needy, you're very sulky, you're very, you know, you can be quite spiteful, you're not sincere, you're not loyal. Well, then that's not the truth, really, because the Queen of Cups is, she's a sweetheart, basically. She's loving, she's warm, she's kind. And, you know, use your intuition when it comes to this. If you feel that this isn't working for you, go with your intuition, because the Queen of Cups, you know, she's psychic. Her intuition is usually spot on. And it could be, as you know, the thing is with the Queen of Cups, she is a very loyal person. She is a very loyal, committed friend. But it's like, I'm getting this energy is trying to turn people against you here. So what does my parties need to know? What should they be aware of, Spirit? What should they be aware of? I don't know why I'm picking up that as well. I feel like this person likes to drink a lot of wine. And once they've had a few, they get a bit... they start texting you or, you know, phoning you with abuse. So we've got Four of Cups, what you should be aware of, Knight of Pentacles, the World, and the King of Cups. This is bringing you no satisfaction, pile two. You're feeling really dissatisfied with it all, fed up. You know, look at the way she's really fed up in this. You know, something that you used to love doing, you were really excited about doing this with these people, with this person, and now it's just become like, oh for God's, I just really can't be bothered, you know. And she looks really sad. I feel really sorry for her. But also this energy as well that's come through feels like you've rejected them. You've turned your back on them. And maybe you have. Can't blame you if it's causing a lot of headache in your life. But Spirit is saying that you've been thinking about a long time. You've been thinking for a very long time about moving away from this energy here, or moving away to do something different here. So you have taken your time and you have thought about it, you know, properly. You've not just rushed into it. And you want to close the chapter here with the World. It's an ending. It's you know, you're done with it because you're frustrated. You know, it failed, basically. These endeavours that you went on with this person, it just literally just fell apart. You know, you're calling judgment on this. This is you making a decision and you just walking away, basically. And the thing is with the judgment here, Spirit is saying don't feel guilty. You've got a lot of guilty feelings, and I feel like this is why you're still here putting up with this, because you feel guilty turning your back on, you know, like I said, it may not just be one person, it could be a group of you, and you feel so guilty if you do this and you're worrying about things and you're delaying it, because the Knight of Pentacles is a delay. It is a long time. It's like taking your time to act. And Spirit is saying here, you need to close this chapter. You do what you got to do. Everybody's got free will. This is just what Spirit is saying, what the cards are saying here. You know, you've completed this goal that you've set out to do. It, you know, the World is completion. There's nowhere else to go with this person or whatever it is that you lot are involved with, okay? You are the King of Cups. You know, look at the way he's meditating here. And it could even be that this could be your partner, because the King and Queen of Cups is a couple. It's a partnership. This could be someone like a guru, because look at this, like a guru. So the King of Cups could be someone that you can actually rely on and talk to. This is like a mentor to you, okay? Even if it is your partner, this is someone that is very compassionate, very caring and calm, you know, and they will advise you in what to, maybe they have been advising you in what to do, you know, but leaving you to do it yourself. They're not forcing you to make a decision, okay, pile two? So let's get some advice for you. What advice would you have for my pile two spirit? Yeah, this is like petty jealousy, petty energy here. And I do feel like you have ghosted this person. Look, look at this. You're the Queen of Wands. I mean, come on, guys, pile two. Spirit is saying you have the strength to go after your dreams. The Nine of Cups is dreams and wishes coming true and feeling fulfilled. You know, this is good health, this is abundance, this is material wealth. Look at the yellow in there. You know, look at the gold in the treasure box down here. You've got this bright future ahead of you. You just need to find the strength to do this, you know, for you. And you do have the strength to do this. We've got Leo energy here as well. Spirit is saying take control back of your life with the strength card. Have confidence. Okay? And the Queen of Wands. The Queen of Wands is somebody that is very confident, is very successful, independent, financially stable, you know, she's just the best, basically. She's the best. And there's better partnerships out there. If you feel like, wow, look at the Ace of Pentacles as well. If you feel like, you know, when I said earlier that there may have been another job offer here, or, you know, a different road that you want to take, you know, this is two people coming together, you know, two like-minded people. It could even be this King of Cups here. But it also says love yourself with the lovers as well. Put yourself first. Stop worrying about everybody else. Stop worrying about this energy. It's not your problem. If you're miserable, sometimes you have to put yourself first. You've got this beautiful abundance, financial stability, a new career, a new direction in life, success. You know, look at all this yellow. So yeah, this is investments, new jobs. So let's get some letters for you, see who this energy is. So this could be like the letters in their name or their initials, or you could even spell out their name. A couple more. So we have a Y, H, T, I, we've got V, we've got another Y, we've got W, we've got D, pulled out quite a lot here, Z, B, Q, a G, an N, and another N, and an O, and a G. So that, you know, you could even maybe spell their name out with that, or they're the letters in their initials or their name. So my pile two, I'm going to leave it there. If this resonated, please hit like and comment down below. Love hearing from you guys, and you have a beautiful Saturday. Bye. Hey, pile three. So if you chose this blue pin here, this is your reading, so let's put that aside, tarot aside for a minute. Let's find out what the tea is on you, lovely pile three. So spirit, tell me, what is the gossip on my pile three, please? What is the gossip on my pile three? Social media stalker, always on your socials, keeping tabs on you, always viewing your updates. So this, whoever this is or energies are, we don't know whether it's one person or more, they tell people that you like to, you're a social media stalker, basically, my pile three. I mean, come on, who don't social media stalker? Bloody do. You have a big ego, inflated sense of self, being self-centered, self-absorbed, thinking the world rolls around you. So yeah, this energy here is saying that your ego is the size of the planet, basically. I don't know why I just heard that part three. Oh god, glowed up, physical and mental transformation for the better, looking yourself in the mirror. This is why there's jealousy here, because you've had some kind of glow up, pile three. You're looking good, you're feeling good, you're living your best life, and this person can't handle it. They're most probably, I don't know why I'm hearing plastic surgery. Don't know why I'm laughing, but this energy here is making me laugh. It's just so stupid. It's like, I feel like they're telling people that you've had work done, not pile three. Maybe you have, who cares? Water sign. This situation involves a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. So you could be the water sign, or they could be the water sign, okay? All right, let's see those two. We have Loki. Under the radar, not giving yourself away, being to yourself, not causing attention. So they, and I feel like this is where they're irritated, because you are someone that is low-key, that you do keep yourself to yourself, and you don't give yourself away. You don't trust everybody. So I'm picking up, you know, maybe Aquarius vibes here as well, air sign. You know, you have your inner circle of friends that you can trust. So I feel like this is why there's a bit of a resentment here. Yeah, look, twin sister. This person wants to be you. Copying someone for their work ideas, how they dress and act and talk. But this energy here is telling people, the gossip is that you copy them, you copy their dress sense, you copy the hair, you know, that kind of thing. Wow. So let's find out who this person is. So tell me who this energy is. My pile three. Someone that is local. This one is living in the same area, city or country as you. So they're local to you. Cancer again. Strong Cancer vibes. So I'm not going to read the positive side of it. I'm going to read the negative side, because we're trying to find out who this is. So this is someone that will get clingy, jealous, pessimistic, easily hurt and dramatic. So we've probably picked up jealousy. Well, flying out. This is someone that is robust, you know, works out, quite, you know, muscly. You come from a different background. Someone who is not in your circle or comes from another country, area, culture, bracket, background, or does a different job to you. So this could be someone that is, you know, a different culture to you, different kind of background, upbringing to you. They're medium height. Aries here. So very quick tempered and can get childish, impatient, arrogant when out of balance. Let's get one more, please, spirit. Not all of them. Unimaginative, takes things seriously, orthodox, hard to adapt. This person finds it hard to adapt to certain situations or people. Okay, let's get their physical features as well. So spirit, tell me what the physical features is of this energy from a pile three. They have cat eyes, younger woman, so they could be younger than you. So what is the physical features of this energy? That is gossiping. High cheekbones. Oh god. They have long hair. What is the gossip? Who is this? I've lost my train of freaking thought now. They like to wear glasses, or they could wear glasses, or they could be into sunglasses, because he's actually wearing sunglasses. They love hats, so they could be quite quirky in the way they dress. Let's get a few more. My eye is burning. I've got moisturizer in my eye. They've got blue eyes. Be more spirit, please, because you know there's a lot of people that watch this. His energy's been a bit stubborn. Whoa. Ow. For some of you, they could be tall. I'm going to get one more. Oh, sod it. So, this person could have brown eyes. You know, don't forget there's a load of you that watches this. They could be a middle-aged man. They could be an Italian descent. Short hair for some of you. And they have scars. And if this person... Oh, that scar's just jumped out at me. If this person has a scar, it could even be you, part three. I'm seeing a tattoo covered up as being... They've had a tattoo that's covered up this scar, okay? So, you know, that's for some of you. So, let's have a look. So, So, what is the gossip on my pile three spirit? What is... Tell us more about this energy here. What are they gossiping about? Five of Wands. The Sun. The Lovers. The Fool. Oh, dear. Okay. Okay. Is this a karmic? The Star, Aquarius, and I said Aquarius energy. So we've got Leo energy, we've got Gemini. Wow. Just bear with me a minute, guys. Bear with me. Tell me about this Lovers. Tell me about the Lovers. Who is the Lovers? Who is this? Who's that, the Lovers? Tell me about this. This energy is paying me off. It's like they don't want me to tap into their energy here. Tell me about the Lovers. Came out like that. Death. Okay, I left the thingy cups there. That, let's take that as well because that stayed there. I feel like you're dealing with a karmic here. So, I'm seeing two scenarios here, okay? This can be your ex, okay? Or it can be your partner's ex, okay? So, there's two scenarios here. Now, this energy does not want to let go of this connection here, this relationship, this love, you know, this person here with the Lovers, okay? They're feeling very bitter with the Queen of Swords that's come out sideways here. This is someone that has been deeply wounded, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius again. So yeah, someone that's been deeply wounded, something's come to an end here because we've got death here, something ended. So it could be if you ended it with your person, this person can't let go. So they're the ones that are gossiping about you, you know, putting bad mouth in you basically because they're feeling hurt and resentful that you dropped them basically, you know, you dumped them. If it is the karmic, and they got dumped, they got rejected, she or he is feeling very bitter, okay? Because the Queen of Swords is someone that can be quite cruel and can be very obsessive and, you know, narcissistic when she's seen in a negative way, but it's also someone that's been deeply wounded as well that carries these wounds around and, you know, them wounds go very deep. And this is someone that's still desiring either you or is, if it is the karmic, they're still desiring your partner. You could be younger because this stayed behind when I was shuffling the cards. You could actually be younger than this energy here because the Queen of Swords is someone that's more mature. You know, I am picking up you are younger, pile three. You know, you've still got the youth, youthfulness about you, you know, and I feel like that's where the jealousy comes in as well towards you. This person's caused a lot of problems in your life, you know, they've caused a lot of, you know, it could be even inner conflict within yourself. It could be that maybe you're feeling insecure about yourself because of what this person's saying about you. You could be doubting yourself. But I feel like there is a group of people that do tend to gossip about you. You know, it could be five people. You know, and with the sun here and with the lovers here, this is two people being in love. This is some, you know, this is happiness here with whoever you're with. You know, you bring this person joy, they bring you joy and happiness. Yeah, I am getting very strong vibes that this is a karmic here, guys. I do feel like this is somebody's ex here that's really just gung-ho against you because they are so bitter that their person is with you now, you know. And I feel like this is why this, you know, with the social media stalker here, even though they're telling people that you're stalking them, no, that's not the case. They're stalking you. So they're obviously seeing pictures online with you and your person. And, you know, they're seeing how happy you both are. And they can't bear this. They can't bear that you and your person have gone off into a new beginning with each other with the Fool. You know, there's an innocence about your connection with your person here. It's very sweet. You know, it's genuine. But this Queen of Swords here would like it to end. But, you know, and as I said before, this is somebody that things came to an end with her person, you know. And she's feeling very bitter. So tell us a bit more. What is this Queen of Swords gossiping about? Two of Pentacles. Oh, wow. Whatever. Sharp. 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 Sorry, I'm having a stupid moment. Oh, whatever. I mean, maybe it is the case. You don't even know what I'm on about, but I can see the cards, what they're saying, what this Queen of Swords is telling people is that she was juggled, she or he, because I forget their energies, that she was juggled, she was put in a third party, she was cheated on with the Three of Pentacles, because that can be a third party situation, the Two of Pentacles is juggling two people as well. And that's why things ended, that's why this person left her, you know, because she was juggled, they were cheating. And you're a homewrecker, basically, is what I'm hearing. So this is the gossip. What else is this Queen of Swords telling people, Spirit? What else are they gossiping about? So we had death twice. That's Scorpio energy. Got Pentacles, which is Earth. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So what else is this energy gossiping about, Spirit? I like this. All the piles have been different. I like that. I hate it when sometimes you get a crossover with energies that like to come in and butt in other reading, like in the other piles. So we've got the Hurt Justice. This is all like this. Eight of Wands, Princess of Wands. They're telling people that this is unfair. That the fairness in this was, you know, that what happened to them was not fair. And what this Queen of Wands is doing at the moment, they're wanting people to take sides. She wants people to take her side in this situation. And it could be working because we've got Five of Wands here. There could be people that is ganging up on you here, okay? And there's a lot of communication here. There's a lot of text messages, you know, WhatsApp messages, phone calls between people here that I'm seeing with the Eight of Wands. And this is them wanting payback for what has happened. You know, this is someone that's planning, someone that's scheming, you know, this is phone calls, messages. And you at the moment, my palfreys, are actually in hiding, you know. Did we not get one like that, that you are, yeah, low-key we got? I feel like you are being low-key at the moment because of this situation. You just don't want to get involved with it. So you're not. You're not going out much, you're not maybe not on social media much. But this is also, this energy here, I don't know whether you're aware of this with the Hermit, is that they could be sharing your social media with other people as well, like giving your name to other people so they will harass you online. So it is sharing information, just a warning there for you guys, okay? It could be what, you know, how are these people getting hold of me? Maybe you need to lock down your social medias like your Instas and your Facebooks and what have you, and your Twitters quite tight, guys, okay? Because this is what is happening here. You've got this bombardment of messages coming at you, you know, harassment. Wow, this person is bitter. So, any advice here in regards to this Queen of Swords for my palfrey spirit? Any advice? Oh, okay. Six of Wands in reverse. Three of Wands in reverse. Three of Swords in reverse. Prince of Cups in reverse. Wow. Okay, the advice spirit is telling you here, my palfreys, okay, with the Six of Wands in reverse, you know, upright is success, it's, you know, good news, happiness, okay? You know, being in charge of a situation, but what spirit is saying is with the Queen of Wands, Queen of Swords here, she's not in charge of nothing. She will not be getting any success out of this. If anything, it's actually going to backfire. She's sitting there with the Three of Wands when it's upright. It's waiting for your ships to sail in. It's waiting for something to happen. It's yearning for someone, you know, and that's obviously what she is doing. But spirit is saying she can wait forever. This person is not coming back. Okay, with the Three of Swords here in reverse, this person is done. Yeah, the Three of Swords in reverse. This is, you know, getting over heartbreak. She will get over it, is what Spirit's saying. In time, she will. She'll give up. You know, she'll stop. She'll heal from this. Okay? Maybe you're just thinking to yourself, is this ever going to freaking end? Yeah, this is someone that still has feelings for someone here, but the feelings are not recuperated, the feelings are unrequited here. Wow, I've never had so many reversals. So what advice would you give my palfrey spirit? Get a little bit more advice for you guys. Wow. Okay. Oh my goodness. Queen of Cups in reverse. Ace of Swords. King of Pentacles and the Nine of Pentacles. Okay, you're dealing with a King of Pentacles here, guys. Your partner could be a business owner. You could even be married to this person now, or planning on getting married to this person. Yeah, this Queen of Swords is still in love with your person here. And if you There's just a little warning message here for some of you, okay? Not all of you. If you are getting married, and I'm hearing something to do with the wedding cake, I don't know whether this person would know what venue you used or what you're going to be using, but they're going to try and sabotage the wedding cake. Don't ask me why. That's just come to me, but that has. So there's a little warning for you there, okay? So yeah, the King of Pentacles is a provider, someone that's very loyal, very stable, you know, financially abundant, takes care of his own. And he or she didn't love this Queen of Cups. This Queen of Cups, this Queen of Swords was somebody that was just, oh my goodness, someone that was just very insecure. Very needy, you know, they it's like they didn't want this King of Pentacles out of their sight. Someone that was very sulky. Even this Queen of Cups could have actually cheated on this King of Pentacles. That may have been why it's come to an end, but this Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Swords is going around telling everybody that it was them that cheated, that them, you know, projection, you know, gaslighting other people. You know, this is somebody that's actually, you know, living in luxury, you know, doing very well for themselves. It could be that they were single for quite a while before they met you. You know, this is what's actually showing here. It's showing that they were single for a while. You know, they were missing their 10th pentacle, which was you. So the Ace of Swords is truth and clarity here. It's the truth that's being revealed here to you. And also when the Ace of Swords comes out, Spirit's saying the tarot readers, what they're saying is the truth. So let's just get a little bit more advice for you guys and then we'll close out the reading. The King of Cups, the Wheel and the Six of Pentacles. Yeah, you're dealing with someone that is actually the King of Pentacles as well as the King of Cups here, guys. You know, this person is stable as the King of Pentacles, but they're also emotionally available as well. They're very loving, compassionate, you know, caring, affectionate, charming. You know, there's this softer side to this King of Pentacles, and this is somebody that wants a relationship to be equal. And I do believe that your relationship is very equal. You know, it's 50-50, it's give and take, and this is cause and effect here. This was destined to happen. You two are destined to be together with the Wheel of Fortune here. Okay, things are going to start looking up for both of you. You know, all this drama here is soon to end here. You know, you've got the Star, which is wish fulfillment, manifesting your dreams. It's hope for the future. The Eight of Pentacles is working hard. You know, you're both going to be working very hard in this connection here together. You know, putting in the effort. Look at this, guys. Ten of Pentacles. You can't go wrong with this. This is... wow, guys, this is a beautiful connection. Absolutely beautiful connection here. You've got the Ten of Pentacles, which is generational wealth. This is two people building a life together, you know, leaving a legacy to their children, and then their children to their grand, you know, their children, you know, that kind of thing. This is guaranteed success. And the Two of Cups is a soulmate connection. You two were destined to be together, like I said, with the Wheel of Fortune here. It could even be a proposal of marriage. Like I said, you know, if you're getting married or it's not happened yet, just watch that cake. I'm just worried about that cake. I don't know what that is. Just ignore me. So let's get some letters for you guys, okay? Let's get some letters. So this could be in their name. So this could be their initials, of who's gossiping about you, or the letters could be in their name, okay? Okay, so we have L, I, H, T-R-Z-B-G-I again, and F and a Y. So, guys, I'm going to leave it there. If you like this reading, if it resonated, please hit like, comment down below. Love hearing from you guys, and you have a wonderful Saturday. And I'll see you soon. Bye.